didn't ask me.
Oh, hi, and welcome to another episode of LP and Laundry. First time, here's how it works. I play one side of an unusual record we talk about a little bit before. Occasionally some wacky commentary appears at the bottom of the screen, and over the course of it, I'll fold some laundry. It's not really about the laundry, but I have been told that it is oddly compelling. This week, well, it's been a while since we've featured the squeeze box. The old Yankovic attractor, the accordion. And, I mean, sometimes you buy an album for the cover, right? And you also buy an album because it's an accordion band. Granted, a one gorilla band in this case. The name of the album is They Said It Couldn't Be Done. But they didn't recognize, that's what it is, they said it couldn't be done, but they didn't reckon with the Mighty Accordion Band. I don't really know what else to say other than to mention that there is, of course, I mean, obviously, this cannot go without some sort of an explanation, so there is plenty of persuasive essay on the back. Including a track by track. I won't read the track by track. Before I do that, you know, there is a little section about the cover. It's right down here. Pictured in his Empire drawing room is Mr. Joseph Kong Young, composer of Concerto Untouched by Human Hands, of Thinking Apes Music, an advocate of stereo at its most simian. If you suspect trickery, you are correct. Joseph is not really a gorilla. If he were to take off that phony gorilla suit, you'd see he is actually a very large gibbon. Among his other duties, Mr. Kong Young is vice president in charge of turnover. Accordingly, he thanks you for turning this album over to find out what it was they said couldn't be done. Actually, genuinely funny little bit of writing there, if I do say so my own darn self. Now, on to the essay. Scoffers, unfazed by their predictions concerning Fulton's folly and the Wright brothers' contraption, claimed it was preposterous. They said it was impossible to combine a big batch of accordions, usually considered strictly solo instruments, into a meaningful, cohesive whole, then add other instruments and get anything that resembled good music or good stereo. Here is the magnificent refutation, a wonderful new sound created by 20 accordions playing the main role, plus harp, guitar, bass, bells, xylophone, drums, timpani, and other percussion instruments. Oh yes, and a boat whistle as well. Exceptionally good stereo recording provides ample room for them all. One thing, though, if you're looking for a nice old-timey accordion album with Lady of Spain and the like, it should be pretty clear already that this isn't it. For the quality of the big sound produced by massed accordions simply does not resemble one squeeze box playing away all by its lonesome. I apologize for poorly scanning that. Instead, it's like a magic new kind of organ, and at the same time, uncannily, like the strings, reeds, and brass of some beautifully blended, unique orchestra. For the listener, music by the Mighty Accordion Band can be summed up simply, more fun than a barrel of monkeys. There, by the way, is a little schematic of the arrangement of both the instruments as well as the microphone placement. Quite handy, I think. I don't know if the left-right stereo will be exactly the same on that, but, you know, one side will sound like one thing and the other side will sound like the other, depending on how well my little stereo microphone picks up said separation. And yes, I know more fun than a barrel of monkeys has nothing to do with an ape, but, you know, they can't be perfect. They didn't say it couldn't be. I don't even know where I was going with that. How about, you know, I'm just stalling. right? Why am I stalling? Why am I delaying the pleasure of the Mighty Accordion Band? Because I'll tell you one thing, I'm not going to say it couldn't be done. They did it. First track is The Syncopated Clock. Next up, Holiday for Strings. Thank you. Next up, April in Paris. Next up, Tenderly.
Thank you.
Next up, Caravan. Last up, the Donkey Serenade. Pretty much a kind of your perfect LP and laundry record, right? It It's instrument specific. It has plenty of persuasive essay copy in the back, and it's a profoundly strange cover with, I believe, our first gorilla ever to be featured on LP and Laundry. And gorilla suits, of course, instant laughs. Are they a little lowbrow? Yes, a gorilla suit just for laughs is not the highest. As a matter of fact, back in my old stand-up days, there was a particular club that people could pay a certain amount of money for somebody's birthday, and between the acts, the manager's sister would dress up in a gorilla suit and have clothes on top of the gorilla suit, and then the gorilla suit gal would do a striptease for that birthday person. And then I got to follow that. Sometimes I miss stand-up comedy. Sometimes. Thanks, as always, for joining me. If you'd like to keep in touch with things, well, first off, you want to like, share, subscribe, and whatnot. Make sure that other people kind of know about this. If you think that maybe this might appeal to somebody, gorilla suit fans need not apply. If you'd like to see an archive of all previous episodes uploaded to YouTube, you can go to mattfugate.blogspot.com. Once again, that is mattfugate.blogspot.com. And on those blog entries, I will, of course, post photos of my copies of the front and back cover of those albums. You can also keep in touch on Facebook. You can go to facebook.com/LP Laundry. No and or ampersand in there, just facebook.com/LP Laundry. Well, that about wraps it up, right? A solid effort, I think. So, be safe out there. Be careful. Wear a mask. Even if